there's many people that are interested in trying to invoke these sort of, many of them older ways of transformation. So I'll make a plug for one of my closest colleagues, two of my closest colleagues, Rakesh and Sandra Jain, J-A-I-N. They have developed a program called the Wild Five, which is this fascinating online-based resource that basically combines exercise, diet, sleep, social connectivity, and what an idiot, I can't think of the fifth one since I'm involved in all this stuff. Let's see, diet, exercise, sleep, social connectivity, and meditation.
Meditation.
Yeah, mindfulness. And it's a beautiful program because it's all, you know, it's completely sort of user-friendly and not overwhelming and doable. And it uses a lot of sort of things like tracking your behavior that sort of make people get kind of feedback. So I've been involved in this work with them because we do so much medical education together and we do some research together. And the results are really striking. Man, people do it for 30 days and they feel way, way better. So Rakesh is one of the great psychiatric leaders at the interface of pharma. The guy is very deeply involved in sort of, he's a pharmacologist like me, but you know, way up there. But over the last 10 years, while not abandoning that, he's become utterly convinced that that is not the final way forward, that we really need to move into these sort of transformative wellness practices. And so, you know, the king of pharma goes into this, and he brings some of that expertise into it. But it's a classic example. And I mean, they and I, many of us are now talking about, well, how can we develop, you know, various levels of programs that interdigitate these sort of wellness practices.
What was the name of the program again?
The Wild Five.
The Wild Five.
Yeah.
And do they like give you advice on like protocols to follow for a diet?
Absolutely.
Oh, cool.
It's all kind of protocol manualized. Uh-huh. Oh yeah, they've published a book. Yeah, if you just Google Wild Five
Wild
together.
Five.
Oh yeah, you definitely will find it.
It's kind of like the, you know, those five things are so incredibly important. I mean, sleep. Of course, sleep deprivation, all that's been shown to be associated with depression or cause depressive symptoms.